Welcome everyone. Today we will introduce hyper-reduced order model techniques for nonlinear systems. Nonlinear systems introduce difficulties when applying projection-based reduced order models. To see that, let's compare how projection-based reduced order model work for linear and nonlinear systems. First, for linear problems, let's consider linear ordinary system of equations whose dimension is large. As usual, in projection-based reduced order model, we approximate solution vector U as a linear combination of reduced basis vectors, which is represented by phi times U hat. We plug this representation into the governing equations wherever U appears. Then we get phi times time derivative of U hat equals system matrix A times phi times U hat. This is an overdetermined system. That is, it has more equations than unknowns. Plus, phi scales with the full order model size. We should not have any term with full order model size. To get rid of the full order model size term, we multiply both sides by phi transpose. Note that phi transpose times phi is identity matrix because phi is an orthonormal matrix. Therefore, this term goes away. Then it left with the time derivative of U hat equals phi transpose times A matrix times phi times U hat. Note that phi transpose times A times phi becomes a small square matrix A sub hat, and this can be pre-computed because the system matrix A is constant. Therefore, the resultant reduced order model for linear system is completely free of the full order model size. This guarantees that this form of reduced order model will achieve a tremendous speedup with respect to the corresponding full order model. Let's look at now a linear problem, which is described by a system of ordinary differential equations with nonlinear function f on the right-hand side. As in linear system case, we introduce solution approximation as a linear combination of reduced basis, which is represented by phi times u hat. Now let's plug this into the governing equations wherever state vector u appears. Then we get phi times the time derivative of u hat equals nonlinear function f and its argument phi times u hat. Again, this is an overdetermined system, so we are going to multiply both sides by phi transpose. Again, phi transpose times phi is identity matrix, so this term goes away, and left with the time derivative of u hat equals phi transpose times nonlinear function f and its argument phi times phi hat. Let's examine the right-hand side more closely. Full order model size phi transpose gets multiplied by full order model size nonlinear vector function f. Unfortunately, this matrix vector multiplication cannot be pre-computed because the nonlinear function f changes every time its argument phi times u hat changes. Therefore, it is inevitable that the final reduced order model for nonlinear systems still has terms that scale with the full order model size. This causes a significant slowdown. Sometimes this form of reduced order model is slower than the corresponding full order model, defeating the original motivation of reduced order model, that is accelerating the full order model simulation. Therefore, it is crucial to get rid of the full order model scale from this reduced order model form. The method of removing full order model dependency is called hyperreduction. Here, we will go over one particular hyperreduction method called collocation method. Now let's start with the reduced system of equations from the previous slide. What if we only need to evaluate a subset of nonlinear term that is marked by blue dots? This implies that we only need to store certain rows of reduced basis phi, which are marked by blue lines, because other rows will not contribute to the matrix vector multiplication. This action gets rid of the full order model scale in the matrix vector multiplication. How about the full order model size dependency of this matrix vector multiplication for the argument of the nonlinear vector function? Because only subset of the nonlinear vector function needs to be evaluated, only the rows of the reduced basis that are necessary to compute the selected component of the nonlinear vector function needs to be stored, which includes the rows that correspond to the selected component of the nonlinear vector function and the neighboring rows that are contributed to the evaluation of the selected nonlinear vector function. This completely removes the full order model scales in the resultant reduced system of ordinary differential equations. Now there is a question we need to ask and answer. That is, how can we find an optimal set of sample points for nonlinear function vector? To explain this, we will focus on this matrix vector multiplication, that is phi transpose times f. The resultant of the matrix vector multiplication is a vector with reduced order model size. Each element of the resultant reduced vector is determined by an inner product of a row vector and nonlinear vector function f, which can be written as sum of individual pairwise scalar multiplication. By the way, not all the terms in the sum will contribute equally to the resultant scalar value also of 1. Some of them will contribute more than others. For example, let's say these three terms are dominant terms, which correspond to these three locations in the inner product. By choosing these three terms only, we are approximating the inner product. By the way, this shows a hint on how to choose sampling elements. We can simply find dominant terms. There are more than one way of determining a list of dominant terms. First, we could look at the dominant columns of the phi transpose matrix, where the dominant column can be determined by comparing the norm of each column and choosing the first few largest. The second approach is to look at the nonlinear vector functions instead of the reduced basis phi matrix. But we have a problem here. The nonlinear vector function is not constant and it is only a vector. The dominant element will change every time the nonlinear vector function is evaluated with different arguments. Therefore, we must have some sort of representation for the overall behavior of the nonlinear vector functions. This can be accomplished by constructing a reduced basis for nonlinear vector function as we constructed reduced solution basis for the solution vector. That is, we collect nonlinear function snapshot vectors, apply singular value decomposition, truncate the left singular matrix, and use it as reduced basis representation for nonlinear vector function phi sub f. Note that we can use phi sub f to pick a list of dominant rows for average behavior of the nonlinear vector functions, for example, by picking the first few largest norms of rows. By the way, how we measure the dominance affects the determination of the sampled rows. There are several measures available, so it is worthy of a separate YouTube tutorial. All right, this was about the collocation method. There is another famous hyperreduction method of downscaling the complexity of nonlinear vector function. It is called DEIM, which stands for discrete empirical interpolation method. To explain the DEIM, we must recall from the previous slide that it is possible to construct a reduced basis that represents an overall behavior of nonlinear vector functions. That is, the nonlinear vector function f can be approximated by the product of the reduced basis phi sub f and the nonlinear term generalized coordinate f of hat. Now, the DEIM finds the nonlinear term generalized coordinate f of hat by an interpolation problem, which can be solved by this least squares regression technique. Here, the matrix Z transpose is a sampling matrix that extracts a selected rows of the nonlinear vector function and basis. Therefore, the action of the sampling matrix to F and phi sub f reduces the size of the resultant vector and matrix. The solution of the least square problems is well known, that is f of hat equals Z transpose time phi sub f pseudo inverse times Z transpose times f. We plug this into the reduced basis form of the nonlinear vector functions, then we get f equals phi sub f times Z transpose times phi sub f pseudo inverse times Z transpose times f. We plug this into the right-hand side of the reduced ordinary differential equations. We get finally the reduced system of ordinary differential equations that do not scale with full order model size anymore. Note that these terms can be pre-computed once for all So this can be efficiently solved by a time integrator scheme. We have applied reduced order model approach to time-dependent nonlinear elasticity problem. The usual kinetic condition that relates position and velocity or the displacement and velocity is used. Initial displacement use of zero is set zero. Initial velocity function v is defined so that the sinusoidal up and down motion is induced. We set our parameter to be frequency and amplitude of the sine function for the initial velocity condition. We have used two training points, that is 3.9 and 4.1, and tried to predict the solution for 9 different parameter points. For example, dynamics for mu equals 4.0 is given in this movie. We use 10 position reduced basis vectors, 40 velocity reduced basis vectors, and 71 nonlinear reduced basis vectors with 200 samples points for the DEIM method. Here is a graph showing the accuracy of the hyper-reduced order models. As you can see, all the relative errors are way below 1%. Here is a graph showing the speedup achieved by the hyper-reduced order model for the nonlinear structure problem. The full order model takes in average around 170 seconds, while the reduced order model takes around 20 seconds, which implies a speedup of 8. I hope that you find this reduced order model tutorial helpful. You can find the example of hyper-reduced order models for nonlinear systems in our libROM webpage. You can download libROM and run this example yourself. Please also check out the description below for more information. All right, this was it for today. I will see you again with another libROM tutorial in near future. I hope you will become a fan of reduced order models.